practice of GLP, also medicinal devices and oncology. Is a strong entrepreneurship professional with a doctor of philosophy, PhD in chemistry from Anna University. So I think right now, like the entire world is looking for such kind of a solution. Yeah. So I invite our Professor Rajendran to take up the session. Sir, please.
Thank you very much for your introduction, sir. There is a small correction. That's phyto. I'm a specialist in phyto. Okay. Phyto is a total plants kingdom. So originated from the plant source is phyto. Okay. Our former vice chancellor knows that Mr. Ramachandran sir, I am a man of aloe vera. I am the person who did the project in India 2000, which has got the best REGP in the country. Thereby, I've developed many industries, nearly about 14 industries, created more than 1.5 lakh of people employment generation in the country. So one of the visit had an opportunity to visit Dr. Kalam sir. Then he, after meeting that particular clients, he called me from his office, wanted to say something. Then when I discussed with him, he said, why don't you have done excellent work to the nation, why don't you do something for your hometown? That's the reason I started in my hometown. There is a small research laboratory, particularly, you know, I'm from the rural background. So I started in my venture in my rural background, that is in my hometown. It's a research laboratory that is from starts from cultivation to finished product. So there is a lot of confusion among this. People are saying that without feeding anything also, I mean, fertilizer and chemical, they are climbing at as organic. That is not a way of organic. So the organic practice will have to educate. When you go for an international market of this product, there is a lot of clarifications, lot of testing protocols, a lot of information is required about the residual toxicity. So in order to educate them, to invite the students for the project, and then to give a better production, the phytomedicine, phytoceuticals. So I created my own laboratory in my hometown. Thereby, I'm giving, the projects to the students, and then for we are making commercially for some therapeutic, prophylactic nutraceutical products, phytomedicines, and Indian medicines, of course. I'm not in oncology. I'm totally into phytomedicine, phytoceutical, phytonutraceutical. I'll share a small presentation for your understanding. Can you hear me, sir? Hello?
We can hear you, sir.
Go ahead, sir. Thank you, sir. So coming to the natural products, it's the most important source for the immunomodulation. Nowadays, there's a COVID-19 is a big issue. Everyone is claiming that for the immune reasons. So when the immune is strong, and definitely there is a fighting nature to disease and infestations. There is a comprehensive program for identification, cultivation, evaluation for these herbal medicines has been developed because it's a primary source for health is about 70% to 80% in the world population. Based on the use of the medicine plants derived from the traditional system. There, it has been used for a human and veterinary practice. So generally, I recommend people to go for a natural products into extract form. Now, the current practice is only for the churna, that is the direct churna, direct powders they are using it. But instead of that, if you do extraction and isolating the active compounds, that is the organic source of the inputs, the extraction and isolating the active compounds, which is responsible for the particular to targeting the indications. So it can be used as a food product, can be used as a cosmeceutical, nutraceutical, pharmaceutical, and even for agro also. From waste to wealth, even agricultural, from the waste also can be used for the treatment of the agricultural crops. That is called an eco-friendly, biodegradable product. So coming to phytotechnology and phytomedicine, the phytomedicine obtained the herbal source of the great demand in the developed world, as they are able to cure many infectious diseases. So now the drugs which is from the phyto originating is an outstanding contribution to the modern therapeutics. When we do for extraction process in a scientific way, by enriching the active fraction, definitely there will be a bioefficacy, and that will increase the bioassimilation and more of activations. Then integrating the phytomedicine into the health system should be developed, such as bringing the harmony. The traditional modern system can have the minimum threat to each other. So then this extraction, the phytotechnology, there is a different method of phytotechnology. There is a cold process of the aloe vera, so there is no influence of the heat, which is not required. And the so different category of products can be used, different species used with the different methodology. Now there are artemisinin and anua, I think that is their drug in Madagascar, they are recommending for the COVID-19. In fact, this artemisinin anua, I gave this one to, presentation in the Nigeria, that is in Abuja, NMPDC. It is like an Ayush, like in India, it's an Ayush in NMPDC in Nigeria. So that was in 2012 I gave this the complete technology and production demonstration, everything. Now the Madagascar government has released as a COVID-19 control as a prophylactic uses. So the natural products, coming to the natural products, the potential is increasing by 8 trillions. So the global market insight of plant-based ingredients market is growing trend. So naturally, people are turning towards the eco-friendly natural inputs. Why we need the phytotechnology? So increase the life expectancy globally has led to increase the incidence of lifestyle, that is so many diseases like diabetes, hypertension, anxiety, and cholesterol, particularly for the obesity, is a significant increase in death due to the lifestyle diseases. This happened the worldwide. Where the resources of the natural phyto resource, it's naturally is available about 80%, but what we are using is utilizing only 20%. And that 20% will increase. And then the 80% is contributed by only the Ayurvedic, Siddha, Yunani, Amchi, and the Western homeopathy. The core objective of this is the advancement of the phytotechnology. Now the current practice is there to use only the churnas. If you make it into a more advancement of the phytotechnology in the refined form, innovate the range of the complete application to fill, and this will do for the socio-economic development for the by the establishing a viable low-cost technology as per need of the budget. And the standardization and quality control of these products, the processing will import the export potential. So the indigenous strategy of aimed for cultivation operational additions to be a national vision. So it's another area of biotechnology, which is it's a collection of the scientific techniques used to improve plants, animals, and microorganisms. And the classification of this, the genetic engineering, molecular markers, molecular diagnostic, vaccines, and tissue culture is another thrust area. To enhance the agricultural biotechnology, a safe and sufficient food supply grown in environmental responsible way, essential promote an eco-friendly agri-biotechnology, empathize by promoting an eco-friendly natural pesticides, encourage the organic farming practices, proper use of the agriculture waste for another concern, as burning them to burden the already critical pollution level. So the development of the technology will proper utilization of agro waste will be used for the biocompost for the same plantations. The valuation of the agro products and utilization of underutilized resources. Increase the support and innovative ideas of value addition of agro products utilization under utilized resources. Increase the research and development and production of new agro-based products to set up the state art of the productions unit development for agro products, to train the agro farmers to value addition in their agriculture duties, to promote the phyto-based health products, phytomedicine, dietary supplements, and nutraceutical range of products. So coming to the biofertilizers and biopesticides, the important of the biopesticides is to free from away from the residual toxicity, because nowadays the farmers, they are using for enormous amount of the more than the recommended dosage of the pesticides. So that will retain the plants and leaves, and which the residual toxicity will retain, and that will affect the human consumption. So in order to avoid that, we let to educate them to the inorganic fertilizers and pesticides as a detrimental side effects to human health. So using the biopesticides and bio-organic fertilizers is advocated. So this can be educated through the training program and those who are coming for an entrepreneur as well. The another, the sustainable, another resource is that the sustainable marine resource utilization is the Gulf Manor Marine Biosphere Reserve. The marine resources are being exploited unmindfully. The support measures is identify specific resources and innovative methods to conserve them. To work with the Forest Department for conservation of Gulf of Manar Biosphere Reserve. So similarly for the seaweed also in the Rameswaram area, it's a countless of marine plants which are algae is available. So in the sea as well as the river, lake, and other water bodies. So this can be converted into a value addition products into for more of therapeutic values. For example, that's a deficiency syndrome of the iodine, which may causes the thyroid enlargement that is called the goiter hypothyroidism. So this can be cured by the using the supplement of the seaweeds. The seaweed resources can be utilized. The available plenty in the Rameswaram area can be used for the agar and then algae and other carrageenans used as a food additives. So the measures will be taken care for the consumption of seaweeds as it contains the vital nutrients of the biomedical values. Yeah. Seaweed market potential is increasing the growing trend. It has been used for the food, beverages, pharmaceutical, animal feed, and agriculture products and cosmetics care.
Sir, we've got another 2 minutes more, sir.
Okay. Socioeconomic empowerment. This can be created by socioeconomic empowerment, mostly for the grassroots levels, striving those nook and corner for the coastal community, and an alternative income can be generated by introducing community economic empowerment to take a disseminate for the technologies to the coastal people. So concluding that, considering all these available resources from near around the Rameswaram area, so the Dr. Kalam vision can be implemented. I'll be supporting in always by developing this as a phytotechnology agri biotechnology, marine biotechnology as a areas, as a, all the three areas as a challenges, we shall move forward to innovate the opportunities by using indigenous strategies to the nation vision. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Thank you so much, sir.